Hi friends, welcome to another day in my blog. I would like to wish all the women a very happy Women's Day. And welcome to another day in my vlog. So here I'm starting my morning to night routine. So my morning starts with making oatmeal for my husband. You know, he wakes up in the morning, so he prefers the oatmeal first before the breakfast. So I made that and gave it to him. And the previous night I had soaked some kala chana because I'm making a Kerala breakfast, puttu and kadla curry. So it's all soaked up and I'm going to give it a pressure cook. So I'm adding it to my Instapot vessel. I washed it and I've added some salt to it for giving a good pressure cook. So Instapot is something that I would like to share with all of you. It's a very useful thing for me. So I don't use pressure cooker at all because I do all my pressure cooking in this. Apart from that, it has a lot of options for cooking meat and any poultry and beans, soups, even yogurt. I make yogurt in this. I ferment my dosa batter in this. Lot of things can be done with this. So I don't use my pressure cooker at all now. This is my hands-on thing. I've been started using from 2 years now. And I've kept a coconut outside because I'm going to make a mixture for my gravy. So it's all defrosted. So I'm roasting it with some turmeric, raw whole coriander, Kashmiri chili, a teaspoon of coconut oil and curry leaves. You can see it changed its color, so I'm going to keep it aside to let it cool down and I'll mix it for my gravy. Meanwhile, I took oil, mustard seeds, I cracked some mustard seeds, I'm sorting my onions, then I'll add my chopped tomatoes to it so that I can make a good mixture for my gravy. And now I'll add a teaspoon of turmeric powder, Kashmiri chili powder and salt and give it a good mix. And when it's all grinded, I'll add the kala chana and grind mixture of my coconut that I had made before, and my curry is all done. And now I'm going to make puttu. I've taken a whole wheat, we get a packet of that whole wheat puttu. I have mixing it with some hot water and salt, and I've put it for steaming with some grated coconut. So that's our breakfast for the day. And after that, my daughter, she loves dosa any time of the day. So I always have a backup of dosa batter and she likes it with tomato chutney. So that's hers. So she loves dosa for breakfast any time of the day. After that, she will go for her online classes and she'll be busy with that. Then I'll get back with my routines as what I have to do for the day while she's into it. If she needs any help, she calls me. And I'm making tea for both of us. For me, tea is something I need, one tea a day, because that helps me to run my whole day. It gives me a different kind of energy. So my tea is not very heavy, or I would say I make a very light tea, not much of tea leaves. So that is how it goes in my household. That's my tea I'm going to just give him, and I'm going to also sit and eat my breakfast with my tea. And she is taking a break, and they give some, you know, workout things because kids are at home doing their online classes, so just to move around. So she's busy doing that. And I came down, that's my dryer empty. I'm going to load one load that's ready after wash to the dryer. So dryer is something we don't need to do anything, just load the clothes and put it on the temperature that you require, and the clothes are ready, all dried up outside. That's how we do it here. So there's another load of clothes that's going to go into my machine. My dryer is running. So another load that will be going in. That's the laundry liquid I use. I don't use much of softener because it doesn't go within my family with the skin problems and all. So Dave was good. He was taking a break out of his office. He was raking all the grass to clean it up. We do that quite often. We do that. And after the classes were over, she took her bike and she wanted to go biking for some rounds. She loves to do that. And of course, it's a good kind of exercise too. So my husband and my daughter, they both went for it because my son was sleeping. So I had to stay home. Even I'm planning to buy a bike for myself so that this summer we can all explore together. Usually that's one thing that everybody do here is biking. There are trails also made where we can bike for long, long hours to a longer distance. We had been there once last summer because we are new to this place now. So we are discovering this place now a little more because it's a year that we have come down here, but because of the pandemic, we couldn't. So while they were doing their biking and playing outside, I was just finishing up my work at the kitchen, mopping the kitchen floor, cleaning up the vessels and putting it on dishwasher so that I can start my lunch preparations. So I wipe my floor according to how much it get dirty, but vacuum I do every day. Mopping I do, I think, twice or once in 3 days, like that. Because all my vessels are into the dishwasher, my sink is empty, so I'm loading it. One load is going in before my lunch preparation starts, and after that another load will come. So here I've taken some bunch of vegetables, anything of your choice, and I grinded coconut with jeera, and I've added it to it. This dish is called avial. It's a very healthy. So after it's cooled down completely, you have to add a cup of yogurt and mix it up. That's it. It's all ready. You can add salt according to your taste. And now I'm going to give a tadka to it. I'm taking coconut oil. Once it's ready, heated up, I'll add mustard and curry leaves to it. And I will add on to the avial. Here you can see. It's a very simple preparation, very healthy dish to add on. So I had other curries and my rice was done. So this is the only thing, this and bean sabzi I had prepared. So that's our lunch for the day. I had leftover sambar. So after that, we just went down to a park that's nearby our house. We thought we'll just take a walk and just get freshen up because we stay at home all day. And kids also need some fresh air and good, just to make themselves feel good. So we just came down to this place, and it has a lake. It's a lakeside and a park and a trail. So this is a lakeside where you can see some ducks around. My son especially loves to stand. He can stand for hours and hours and, you know, look at the ducks. And it was a good day, good climate, clear sky with little sun. It was cold but manageable. So there you can see some ducks. We just explored the place for some time. We took some walk and we were enjoying this place for some time. You can see the ducks in the lake. They don't harm anybody unless until you go and harm them. They are just on their own. You can just stand and look at them. It's a very calm and quiet place. During summers, there's a lot of people around here. But because of this ongoing pandemic, the number of people are like very less. Like here and there, you can see some people around. Not like before. You can even go on the other side of the lake. There's a place. You can, you know, walk out, and but the kids didn't want to go that side, so we just stood here and then we went to the trail side. It's very clear water. It's nice, you know. It's like during summers people enjoy it here a lot, doing swimming and things. So this is the other side of the place. It's towards the trail. You can hear the water sound. There's both sides. It's a flowing small river type, and that's the park of this place. We didn't allow them to play because there were a lot of kids around, so just for safety reason we didn't allow them, but we just made them play on the other side of the place. Just we did some running and we played some games. We told them we'll bring them some other day when it's a little bit empty. Like, he wanted to go, he wanted to play, but then we didn't take a chance with so many people there. We just stood at a distance and we were looking. So this is another side of this place. I think it's the trail. This was the trail that we were walking down to. We walked around like half an hour to 40 minutes. We just walked down, we enjoyed the place. So that's the river, flowing river from both sides. It's a beautiful, you know, atmosphere just to relax and calm you down, take a break from all your work and just to come down, walk and having a family time. It's a really good place like that. Like this, there's a lot of trails and parks around our place filled with trees and greenery. It's really nice to see. So here they were playing, they were running up and down, down and up for some time until they got tired. He was tired, now he wanted to go. We just sat there, we sanitized the place and we just sat some time just to... I didn't want to leave the place, so it was very nice, felt good, got some energy to get back to work after going home. Then I had some grocery to pick up, so we went to the grocery store. So that's how our grocery store looks like, the organic section, non-organic, it's the fruits, that's all the snack section. There, the freezer side, you can see it's all milk and cheese. And that's another snack section. You have n number of things with so many choices, you know. So I was just picking up that I need. Basic fruits and veggies for the week. There's all the greens, different type of lettuce and spinach mix, all the salad dressing, juices. Now we were getting back home. I also had my library pick, I picked that. After coming home, we all took a shower and they wanted strawberries. Both my kids, they love strawberries any time of the day. So it has to be a stock in my house. So while they were doing that, I was finishing up other works. The books that I got from the library, I just sanitized all of them. You can see it's wet. Some books are for her, so this is her book. And that's his book. So his books are usually, you know, a lot of pictures and stories, built up stories with pictures. It's nice for their eyes to catch up, and that's how we can build interest for them into books. So he fortunately he loves reading books, so this is something I'm going to start new with him, some wordings and, you know, rhyming kind of word book. So that's our library, King County. We have n number of books here, you know, there's no limit. So many books for any age group. So that's again one of his book I'm just showing you. It's all very interesting and, you know, it catches the young reader's eye. So every week I bring some amount of book and we read through the week. And then we return it and we grab another set of book. That's how we do it. Because that's something I think it's important for kids right now, because my younger one, he's at home, he's not attending school, so I should keep him occupied with so many things. Plus he likes it, so yeah. That's the wipe I use to disinfect anything. So I'm preparing my dinner. So I had soaked rice and I had gone out, so I grinded it with some coconut and I added all the veggies, and just before cooking I added a teaspoon of Eno. And it's, you know, instant to go kind of dish with any chutney or sambar. So that was our dinner for tonight. It's really yummy. I think you all should try it once. So they're all having it. Sometime he eats himself, sometime he needs to be fed. Anyway, food has to go into him. So that's what our dinner looked like. I had it with sambar. So it's nighttime routine and we finished all our dinner brushing. So I was tying her hair and he was talking to me about the story he read. And he was telling me how he'll be, he's enacting something. So that's all from me today, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching my vlog. If you've liked it, please give it a thumbs up, like, share and subscribe and comment to my channel and be a part of this beautiful family of ours. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next vlog. Bye.